How are you today? Lee and I are traveling this week, but I didn't want to miss the chance to come to you live and just share a word that I feel like God put on my heart. And I do. I pray that you're having a fantastic week and that today has been an incredible day and that you're looking forward to a direct encounter with God through the Holy Spirit. And what I want to talk to you today is about respect, particularly respect as it goes for men's needs. And you know, I was out today and by the pool earlier, and I met a gentleman and who happens to be a judge. For 34 years, he's been a judge in juvenile court, and he actually lives in this facility, which was fascinating. And we started talking about affirmation and confirmation and what's important in the lives of men. And he was a juvenile court judge, and talking about the beliefs that he has as far as mentoring and encouraging men and young men. And I really started, and I used this from Matthew 3:17, just to illustrate that it is important for us to receive external affirmation. And I'm not talking about blowing smoke. I'm talking about true life-giving affirmation. And you know, in Matthew 3:17, after Jesus was baptized by John the Baptist, you know, a voice came down and it was God. God was speaking to him and he said, "This is my son for whom I am proud." Now, can you imagine, you know, like if your dad's ever told you, "I love you," or "I am proud of you," I mean, how great did that make you feel? Can you imagine Jesus having God, his father, boom down the voice as I see it, you know, proclaiming, "This is my boy and I'm proud of him." Man, that's amazing. And what an example that set for us. You know, I can share with you, and I'll share with you, growing up, I never heard my dad say, "I'm proud of you, I love you, hey, good job," or really even, "I like you." And that stayed with me through the entirety of my life. It actually became a point where it kind of, you know, it set me down a different path where looking for that affirmation and things that God the Father illustrated, hey, that's important. Our boys, our kids, even men have an innate desire for external affirmation. And I'm not talking about cheering and clapping and giving false praise. I mean, looking another man, your son, your dad, a relative, a dear brother, looking them in the eye and saying, "I am proud of you. I love you. You have done an amazing job." And you know, when we talk with couples, married couples a lot of times, and some, you know, the wife will be like, "Well, I'm not going to respect him until he deserves respect, until he earns respect." And you know, a couple things come into play, right? It's number one, it's like, who are you to judge, right? Like, who are you to set this standard of having earned a certain enough respect that you're going to actually treat with respect? And one thing we tell all of our married couples is to the wives, it's you've got to pray up, where do you want your man to be? Do you want him to be a better lover? Do you want him to be a better father? Do you want him to be better spiritual leader of the household? Then you've got to treat him to the point. You've got to respect him at the point. You've got to pray for him to come to that point of elevation, right? To just leave a kid sitting in an empty classroom hoping he's going to become a physicist is never going to work. But when you fill that classroom with expectation and information and the right education, you're going to elevate that kid by giving him the tools, right? And the respect to spend that time and invest in him to raise him up to that level of the ability to become a physicist or whatever it is, right? So whether it's a better dad, a better husband, a better, whatever the case is where you want your husband to be, treat him at that level and not false praise. But, you know, look, Leah used to like, I was so, you know, I was caught up in my work and she's like, "You know, I wish you would spend more time with the kids, you know, invest more in the kids." And I'm like, "Well, you know, we play and I tell them what chores to do and stuff." No, I want you to invest in the kids. And she had been praying for that. And she had, you know, and one morning, this is years back, one morning I brought them to school. "Man, I appreciate you bringing them to school. I heard they all got there on time." And you know what? Man, I'm an adult. And I was like, I like that. I like the way that felt. I love that compliment, you know? And sometimes people joke, they say men are simple. They're like a dog. You compliment them and scratch them on their head and they can't wait to please. But you know what? That's all part of that servant mentality, that sacrificial mentality. Like, we're willing to give. We're waiting to give, to serve. It's you know, we want to know as men, is that being appreciated? Is it being acknowledged? Is there respect that comes along with it? So the example that God the Father set for us was from Matthew 3:17, when he said, I'm going to paraphrase, you know, this is my boy and I'm proud of you. You know, look, when we tell that to our kids, you see their eyes brighten up. When other people tell it to us, we just feel our hearts begin to soar. So it also goes back to sowing and reaping, right? You want a husband, you want a person that's worthy of respect and respectful, then sow those words of respect into their life. And then you're going to be able to reap a respectful behavior. So it's a great example. It's in Matthew 3:7. It came on my heart as I'm talking to this judge, and we're sitting poolside and talking about, again, just out of the criminal justice system, you know, and God just put it in my heart to share with this guy, this scripture. And you know, even like that, he was like, okay, you know, I could dig it. And because he was looking forward from the secular academic side. But it's such a perfect example, especially men do. We crave respect. And you know, when we receive respect, it changes the atmosphere. And I'm not talking false praise. I'm talking about respect and giving us that level, that bar that you want us to reach. And like I said, it could be from a better dad or a better husband or a better employee or whatever the case. But that's how we do it, right? We give them the tools. We give them the affirmation. We speak life into their light. And it makes us achievable. And when you attain that, then give the praise or the respect that goes along with it, just like God the Father did with his son Jesus. I mean, come on, you know, he had to feel proud, right? He comes out of that water, he's just baptized, and bam, this is my boy, I'm proud of him. I mean, Jesus probably like, yeah. And how wonderful is that? We're the same way. Speak words of affirmation, especially into the lives of men, young boys, across the board, especially during this time of uncertainty with the pandemic, or during this COVID-19 situation, where sometimes men have lost their jobs and they're not sure how they're going to provide for their families, or they feel like they're out of control of their environment and they don't know how they're going to be the man of the house. You know, a lot of times, you know, our capabilities begin to are questioned, and there's chaos and there's uncertainty. So, man, support the men in your life. Support them with words of affirmation and with respect. And it will. It changes everything. So listen, I love you. God bless you. And I'm praying for you.